The charges, sir. I'll hear them again.
My lord, His Majesty's court contends that the defendants, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, did piratically, feloniously, and in an hostile manner attack, engage, and take 7 certain fishing boats. Secondly, this court contends that the defendants lurked upon the high seas and did set upon, shoot at, and take 2 certain merchant sloops, thus putting the captains and their crews in corporeal fear of their lives.
Edward James Kenway, born of motley parentage in Swansea, to an English father and Welsh mother. Married at 18 to Miss Caroline Scott, now estranged.
She's a beautiful woman, I am told, but not at all well these days.
If you touch her, you bastard, I'll...
Quite a surprise finding you here rotting in a Jamaican prison. We heard rumors that you had taken up with the pirate Roberts.
If you know the observatory's location, tell us now, and you'll be out of here in a flash.
Rogers can hold these British hounds at bay for a time, but this will be your fate if you fail to cooperate.
You, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, are to go from hence to the place from whence you came, and from thence to the place of execution, where you shall be severally hanged by the neck, till you are severally dead, dead, dead!
Oh, Ross!
May God in his infinite mercy be merciful to each of your souls!
We're pregnant! Do you all hear that?
What the devil did she say?
They plead their bellies, my lord.
Aye, you can't hang a woman quick with child, can ye?
Quiet! Quiet! If what you claim is true, then your executions will be stayed, but only until your terms are up.
Then I'll be up the duff the next time you come knocking.
Remove them!
Philip, Kenmore, Conway.
It's Walpole, ain't it?
Walpole? Where'd you get that?
Well, that's the rumor going round. As dirty and daft a pirate as ever sailed these West Indies.
Well, whatever his name, gotta make sure he suffers without dying. Orders from the governor. I'm back to the prisons at sundown.
And massage his feet if he's a...
Oi! Water. Stop that!
Oi! This is a warning! Oi!
This is a warning!
Oi!
Oi! Stop that!
Good morning, Captain Kenway. I have a gift for you. Do not mistake my purpose here. I have come for Anne and Mary, and you owe me nothing for this. But if you would lend me your aid, I can promise you safe passage from this place.
I'll need weapons.
You are comfortable with this, I am told. We must hurry.
Hold that.
Well, no, you don't. Come back. Not worth the effort.
Give over. I didn't see him.
Stand still. Hold you. Hold.
Bloody hell. This one. Sights!
Me, Edward.
Edward? Who's this fella?
It's all right, Anne. He's a friend. What's wrong with Mary?
She's ill.
And her child?
They took her. No idea where. Oh!
Oh! Oh! I know it pains, my lady, but we must be silent. Can you walk? Lean on me, Mary. Come on.
I can't.
Search every cell!
Come on, that's it.
You're all right.
Don't die on my account. Go.
This is such a pain in the ass. Damn it. You should have been the one to outlast me.
I've done my part. Will you?
If you came with me, I could. Mary.
I'll be with you, Kim.
What's happened to Mary? What's wrong?
Is she gone?
Oh, no. Oh, God! Oh!
What will you do now?
Nothing sensible.
You haven't earned this, but they suit you. Good fortune to you, Edwin Kenway.
I'd see some color first.
Will this do? In all your years out here, you could never achieve what I've done in one-fifth the time. Because you're a good man, Edward, see? Goodness is your disease.
That's my prize, Roberts. Now give it here!
Remember my creed, boy. A short life and a merry one, that is all. The world owes us nothing more than this. So take what you will, and then die before you live to see yourself made a fool.
Give it here.
That's right, boy, take it.
I'll sweeten you, maggot. I'll cut you!
Calm, little puppy, and slink back to your kennel. You haven't the mettle for my brand of madness.
Robert! Welcome aboard, Kenway. It's prizes, plunder, and adventure ahead. Are you game?
Out of my way, Ben.
Raise a glass to freedom, lads. Here's to gentlemen of fortune and women of leisure.
To a world full of rogues, better than all the kings and queens that kick us about.
As gentlemen of fortune, we enjoy plenty and satisfaction, pleasure and ease, liberty and power. What man with a sensible mind would choose the former life? For I have dipped my hands in muddied waters, and, withdrawing them, find 'tis better to be a commander than a common man!
Just as strong and capable. So, with a great flapping and rustling of feathers, the jackdaw came down swiftly and clutched at the coat of a large ram. But when he tried to fly away, he found he could not lift the animal, for his size and strength were not up to the task. Even as the jackdaw struggled, the ram...
No more than 2 years! You promised me!
You left! When I needed you the most!
But you had me! What keeps you wondering? Do I not make you happy?
I'm so close, Caroline. Please, just let me do this.
It's everything you do out of spite, Edward.
It's not spite that's driving me, Mary. It's courage.
Courage for what, man?
There's no one left in your life to care.
Damn you all. I can handle this.
Out. Always tearing down when you could be building things up. Or building yourself up, if nothing else.
Just leave me be.
Change course, Edward. Change your bloody course before it's too late.
Captain Kenway! You look like a bowl of plum duff.
Christ! Oh, I've got a head for ten.
On your feet.
You put me on the spot, Addy. After leaving me with Robert, I shall have hard feelings about seeing you here. But mostly I'm bloody glad.
Me too, brother. And you'll be chuffed to know your jackdaw is still in one piece.
So we set sail. You're leaving?
Aye, Edward. But I have another calling elsewhere.
Addy, listen.
When your heart and your head are ready, visit the assassins. I think you'll understand then.
Thank you.
Jesus, Addy, what the hell happened here?
You happened here, Edward. The damage you caused 6 years ago has not been undone.
I'm not an easy man to call a friend, am I? Is that why you're here?
To fight beside a man so driven by personal gain and glory is a hard thing, Edward. And I have come to feel the assassins and their creed a more honorable cause. Have I been unfair?
No. For years I've been rushing around taking whatever I fancied, not giving a tinker's curse for those I hurt. And yet here I am, with riches and reputation, feeling no wiser than when I left home. Yet when I turn around, look at the course I've run. There's not a man or woman that I love left standing beside me.
There is time to make amends, Captain.
Mary. Before she died, she asked me to do good by her, to sort out the mess I made. Can you help me?
Mary was fond of you, Edward. She saw something in your bearing that gave her hope you might one day fight with us.
Aye. She told me.
And what do you think of our creed?
It's hard to say. For if nothing is true, then why believe anything? And if everything is permitted, why not chase every desire?
Why indeed?
It might be that this idea is only the beginning of wisdom, not its final form.
That's quite a step up from the Edor I met here many years ago.
Brother.
So what do you think?
It'll take some getting used to.
The second attack this month, I should have moved this village long ago.
I brought all this upon you years ago, but I will stand by you now.
It will take more than a few favors to call yourself a true assassin, Edward.
One thing at a time, mate.
Follow my lead.
Objetivo a la vista.
Jan Muk Awol Yetel Abishan. And once more, you have our thanks, Edward. You are welcome here.
Thank you, sir. I'll rest here for a time before setting up, if I may. How's her child?
She is a strong woman, but not invincible.
Sorry for your loss.
If I'd stayed in prison, they'd have taken him from me. He'd never be alive. Maybe this is God's way of saying I'm not fit to be a mother yet. Carrying on like I do. Cursing, drinking, fighting.
You are a fighter, aye. In prison, I heard stories of the infamous Anne Bonny and
Mary Read taking on the King's Navy together. Just the pair of you.
It's all true. Anne would have won that day if Jack and his letter had passed out in the hold from drink. Edward. Everyone's gone, aren't they? Mary, Bracken, Touch, all the rest. I miss them so. Rough as they were. Do you fear that too? All empty in sight?
I do.
Devil curse me. I know my targets by sight well enough, but how will I find them?
We have spies and informants in every city. Visit our bureaus and the assassins there will guide you.
That fixes Torres and Rogers. But Bartholomew Roberts won't be near any city. It might take months to find him.
Or years. But you're a man of talent and quality, Captain Kenway. I believe you will find him.
And if you're at a loss, don't be afraid to call on your quartermaster for aid.
Quartermaster! What's our present course?
Due west, Captain, if it's still Kingston we're sailing for.
It is indeed, Miss Bond. Call it out.
Weigh anchor and let fall the courses, lads! We're sailing for Jamaica!
How does it feel to bark so loud?
I've barked louder, and to men twice as rough.
Tending bar at the old aviary, you mean?
Among other places. And I sailed with Mary in Rackham for a time, remember?
Of course.
Mary did most of the captaining, Jack.
Captain Kenway.
You have something for me?
The present whereabouts of the Templar Woods Rogers. He is attending a small political function, so do it clean.
The word is King George is calling Rogers back to London.
Aye, not happy with his progress in Nassau.
Still too many pirates roaming about from what I hear.
You'll need a disguise to fool the powderheads at this party. I suggest the visiting diplomat, Ruggero Ferraro. He's been on our list for some time.
Understood. Will you send this to England for me?
Aye. The ship leaves tomorrow.
Caroline Scott Kenway, Hawkins Lane, Bristol.
Gentlemen, a toast to my brief tenure as governor of the Bahamas. For under my watch, no less than 300 of our pirates took the king's coin and brought filth into the crown. And yet, for all my successes, his majesty has seen fit to sack me and call me home to England. Brilliant! God bless the fucker! My own money, fully three-fourths of the improvements made to that bloody island, I...
He was a privateer once. How is it you lack so much respect for sailors only trying to make their way in this world?
You couldn't possibly understand my motives, cretin! You have spent a whole lifetime dismantling everything that makes our civilization shine.
But I do understand. I've seen the observatory, and I know its power. You'd use that device to spy and blackmail and sabotage.
Yes. And yet all for a greater purpose. To ensure justice. To snuff out lies and to seek truth.
There's no man on Earth who needs that power.
Yet you suffer the outlaw Roberts to use it.
No. I'm taking it back. And if you tell me where he is, I'll stop the man.
Here at the edge of a blade, I find a friend in you at last.
Principe, you mad bastard. Our best source is... Say Principe.
not what I came to the New World for. Get away!
You! Stop!
Well done!
That man there! The
what happened?
He did it!
Is Captain Rogers hurt? Is it a revolt? What's happened?
It's done.
Where now?
Grab your kit and pack well. We're sailing for Africa.
taking orders!
Fire!
Still kicking!
Who did this?
It were a large vessel. The Royal Fortune.
Roberts.
Offered no quarter. Didn't say nothing.
Thank you.
How can I not be impressed by the attention you've paid me? May the best of we two sing praises of the second!
You, Edward? Have you found the peace you seek?
I'm not aiming so high as that. What's peace but a confusion between two wars?
Oh, you're a stoic then. But perhaps I was wrong about you. She might have had some use for you after all.
She? Of whom do you speak?
Oh, she who lies in wait. Entombed. I had hoped to find her, to see her again. To open the door of the temple and hear her speak my name once more.
Aye. Talk sense, man.
Oh, I was born too soon. Like so many others before.
Where's the device, Robert?
Destroy this body, Edward. The Templars. If they take me...
Every last scrap of duck on the wind!
Aloft, lads! Loose the royals!